I don't when this trihalite reacts with water and forms boric acid. Boric acid. That is H3BO3 plus HX. Next, write down. In solid AlCl3, in solid AlCl3, aluminium is octahedrally coordinated. It means it has six octahedral number, eight, nahi, six. It has six coordination number.
So what is
coordination number? Coordination number, abhi complex number. Think of coordination number. I'll just explain. First of all, it has six coordination number and two chlorine atoms in each octahedra. In each octahedra are shared between the aluminium atom. Two chlorine atom in each octahedra are shared between aluminium atom. This is crystalline AlCl3, solid. Liquid form, there is a tetrahedra. Okay, I'll just explain what it is. See, AlCl3 actually in solid form, it exists in the form of its dimer. Dimerization takes place. Okay. So AlCl3, when dimerized, it forms what?
Al2Cl6.
Right? Now the structure of this is, we have aluminium. One aluminium is put there. So we have an octahedra. See, octahedral geometry is something like this. Let me explain you this. This is suppose any metal M, and we have suppose this element present. This is octahedral geometry. This octahedral is what? Square?
Bipyramidal,
right? So square is this and bipyramidal. This is octahedral geometry. Okay? So Al2Cl6 exists like this. Aluminium we have here in the center, one chlorine here. This chlorine atom actually, it is bonded like this. This is the dimer structure of this. Okay, how is it? It's donated, it's lone pair, no? AlCl3 mein, jise wo tha na banana bond. Banana bond B2H6, how it forms.
This is
the electron pair, it's donated to this aluminium. So this is a coordinate bond. This is a coordinate bond. Now this coordinate bond will represent by simple bond. Okay.
So how do we know when something will form a
dimer
and when it
works?
Is there a way of
telling? Actually, like AlCl3 is electron deficient. Okay. So AlCl3 is not that stable. So crystal form may this get dimerized and becomes a stable. Okay, what is that structure? Octahedral hota hai, this chlorine also attached with another chlorine atom like this. There's all these things. Other molecule attached like this. It's a chain structure basically. The dimer structure is this, but it attached with the another atom. This is a coordinate bond, you can represent like this also. But nowadays we don't represent this arrow, but we represent the simple bond like this. The structure is, because it's just a rule. If you have third period element, then one single bond is nothing but the coordinate bond, if it is possible. Means by looking at the structure or bond, you cannot say whether it is coordinate bond or simple covalent bond. You should have this idea. Pata hona chahiye tumhe kahan pe coordinate bond hai kya. Is there nitrogen ke saath NH4 plus if you write. Okay, NH4 plus ke saath we'll write like this, no, the structure. This is the coordinate bond. So for third period elements, we represent simple bond like this. But for second period elements, we represent like this. Even if you write this simple bond, right, then we'll have, this is also right. this is just a rule. It's not like in the new edition, new book, they have adopted this particular rule to represent the coordinate bond. Coordinate bond, actually, it forms by the donation of a pair of electrons. So इसमें क्या होता है इसमें the new definition of coordinate bond is what that the electron pair is not originated from the same atom. As I said, atom was two electron है, so it gives one electron to the atom and then sharing takes place. As a definition of coordinate bond. So nowadays coordinate bond is nothing but the type of covalent bond.
So you just give an electron and then
share. That's sharing. Okay. So next write down in. Write down in liquid form, AlCl3 I'm talking about, in liquid and vapor form. In liquid and vapor form, aluminium is coordinated with 4 chlorine atoms.
So why did we draw the blue chlorine guys?
Because this is octahedral, it's coordination, 6 coordination number, right? So aluminium must have, coordination number is what? It is the bond the metal forms with the elements or ligands is a better word to use, right? So this aluminium has 6 coordination number. It means it has 6 bond with this chlorine atom. So 3, 4, 5, 6. This is factual. It is observed in crystalline form, solid state. Okay, that too in liquid and vapor form. Aluminium has 4 tetrahedrally arranged atoms. That's the structure.
Satisfying its coordination number over its octet.
Octet though, it's true only for second period element. In the third period, so d orbital can show expanded octet. Octet actually, it's which
hand? The coordinate number
boron will be 4. Okay. So this exists in vapor and liquid form. Right. Tetrahedrally coordinated, octahedrally coordinated. See, these are the structure based on the fact. Okay, when they have done this, the research on the structure of this, like we have many things, spectroscopy, there are various method of determining that structure, right? So, in liquid state, in crystalline form, this is the structure possible, and in liquid and vapor form, this is the structure possible. So what they ask you, the theoretical question, that here it is, octahedrally coordinated means 6 bond is there with each chlorine atom, each aluminium atom. And here it is tetrahedrally coordinated, that you have to memorize. Liquid and vapor, and this is crystalline solid. Okay, next write down, hydrides of boron. Hydrides simply you write down, hydrides. Write down the elements of group 30 combines directly with hydrogen and forms hydrides of MH3 type . Write down BH3 is the simplest hydride. Two series of hydride it forms. The one is BnHn plus 4. This is one type of compound possible, and another one is BnHn plus 5. So it is B2H6, the dimer form here, and here it is B6H11, one of the compounds. This is not important. Diborane belongs to this series of hydrides. Okay, BnHn plus 4. Okay. B4H10 is the, this is not 5, this is 6 actually. B4H10. Okay, this is the general form of the hydrides, which is diborane B2H6. Okay, so BH3 is the simplest hydrides of boron, which is again electron deficient, and to get stability, it dimerizes and form B2H6. Okay, so B2H6, next you write down diborane. Diborane, it is prepared by the reduction of BCl3 with LiAlH4, lithium aluminium hydride. LiAlH4, lithium aluminium hydride. LiNH4 is a very strong reducing agent. Organic chemistry में लोग देखेंगे इसे. बहुत important भी है and there are many reactions of this. Okay. So BCl3 with LiNH4 in presence of
E.
Yeah. BCl3 with LiNH4 in presence of ether. Reaction right on BCl3 with BCl3 plus LiAlH4 in presence of ether, it forms B2S6 plus LiCl plus AlCl3. LiCl plus AlCl3. So, I'll write down the reaction. We have BCl3. BCl3 ka reaction with LiAlH4. It forms B2H6 plus LiCl plus AlCl3. Another method is what? Iska, if you do the reaction with H2, this is electric discharge. Forms B2H6 plus HCl. That is also the another method. BF3 ka reaction with lithium hydride. That is also a method of formation of B2H6. BF3 plus LiNF. Two moles of this we use. LiBF4. Is it balanced?
Yes, sir.
Oh yeah, 6 BF3. 8. Balanced. This is the reaction. So boron trifluoride with lithium hydride gives you B2N6. Okay, another reaction. Properties of this write down, it is a colorless gas, stable at low temperature. Low temperature.
How low?
See, low we generally don't define, around less than 100 we can say, 60, 80, even in low temperature we also go, even in low temperature we also go till minus 70, minus 78 degrees Celsius, but not that low, it is around 50 something. Right on, at high temperature, it converts into higher borane. And on red heat, higher borane means when likha na do wala series. So second one is the higher borane. Reaction is not there. The second one is the higher borane. High temperature it converts into higher borane, and on red heat it forms pure boron and hydrogen. Red it means extremely high temperature. It forms pure boron and hydrogen. See, B2F6 is the dimer of BH3, correct? Dimer of BH3. So, this BH3, the molecule you see, there are three bonds of boron and hydrogen like this we have. And the another molecule is also this. So what happens, both of this boron has one vacant p orbital. This pair of electron is donated to this boron, and this pair of electron is donated to this boron. Okay, so we'll get a bridge bond here. Structure is HBH. Okay, so here in this bond, there are only two electrons. Four electrons are not there, however there are two bonds present. So what we say, this two electron is shared among the three nucleus, two boron and one hydrogen. Same thing we have here, right? So we have three nucleus, 1, 2 and 3. So it is three center, and since two electrons are shared, so it is three center, two electron bond.
So it keeps going like a circle.
No, generally kya hota hai, we write two electrons here, no? Yahan pe kya hai, the two electrons, it is attracted towards the three nucleus.
How they physically
move? They are not moving, it's not delocalization. It's just they are in a bonding state with these three nucleus. Okay, that's why this kind of bond forms. Okay, so this bond we call it as bridge bond, and this is three center, two electron bond. What is the other name? Banana bond. Why it is banana bond? Because you can. My drive is not good, but it looks like banana. That's why.
So, on that note,
can you see? So, 5 more minutes. Let me finish this. Let me finish this. Okay, thank you. So, just 2 minutes, we'll finish this. Few reactions here. Okay, few reactions. We write down the two, three reactions here. B2S is the reaction. With O2. It forms D2O3 with H2. With H2O it forms H3BO3 and hydrogen gas evolves. KOH KBO2 and H2O. These reactions are there, but these are not very important. The important reaction here is, again, the heating effect of this. B2H6 with NH3. It forms an adduct. We call it as adduct to NH3. Like we have hydrogen compound, this we call it as an adduct. Okay? Now, when you heat this, at 200 degrees Celsius, this converts into, you know, this compound, inorganic benzene, borazole, right? Borazine, inorganic benzene. Okay, the structure of this is what?
So what's the actual borazole?
Borazole is this one.
Borazole.
Borazole, inorganic benzene.